Thank you, Surya. It's my great honor to introduce our honorable chief guest, Dr. Yasho B. Verma. Sir is a business consultant and mentor. He is founder mentor of Instion Solutions Limited and Maxell Learnings. He is also member of executive board of Ford School of Management, Delhi. Sir has worked with Onida, LG Electronics, India, looking after a business of rupees 8,000 crores. Sir was chief operating officer during 2010-11. He joined LG Electronics, India in 1997 as vice president. In 2008, he was the first non-Korean to be elevated as executive in LG India. Sir started his career with Tata Steel in Jamshedpur and worked there for around 15 years. Dr. Verma is an engineering graduate with post-graduation in business administration and PhD in organizational behavior from Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur. Sir was rated as heretic by Business Today and Gallup. He has delivered several lectures in India and abroad. JK Group, Ispat Group Bangkok, Orelicon Italy, GE, etc. He has visited London Business School, Seoul University, and Wharton Management School, Philadelphia, besides many premier management institutes in India for guest lectures. Sir has been conferred honorary fellowship by All India Management Association for significant contribution towards professional management. He was also a member of the Council of Management.
Let me tell you, the young ladies and gentlemen, that you are very lucky to be born in a country like India. You must have been heard a lot of people quite talking negative, but the advantages which you are going to have in your future course, I'll just list out a couple of them. Number one, this is going to be a global world. Japan working force is going to reduce by 40% in next 20 years. There will be no persons, 40% less in Japanese to work in Japan. It will be 30% lesser in China. It will be 25% lesser in USA. That means, where will the manpower come from? And one of the most important country being highlighted by the global countries is India. And that is why we are becoming global. And one big advantage of being born in India, that we have a culture of acceptance. We have got born, bred, grown up with so many cultures, and we accept all of them. This is what is the significance of a global culture. When you'll be in a global company in another country, you'll have to accept their culture. And only then you can be a global manager. This is a major strength of an Indian. This is a major weakness of countries like Japan, Korea, China, and a lot of countries in Europe. We have another very important things. We have a strong culture having family roots and deep-rooted values which young people acquire from their parents. Absolutely different than the developed economies. There they are very lonely people. You travel in a train, local train, and you'll find two or three people talking to themselves in the local trains in US and Europe and vehemently behaving because they have no one to talk to. They are single individuals fighting the battle of life. You have a family, you have parents, you have friends. And you have values which you have imbibed from them, which will stand very strongly in your whole life. And let me tell you, when you become 40 plus, you will not realize it now, when you become 40, 45 plus, you strongly remember the values which your parents had given to you. Your parents who are sitting here will vouch for it, because they are through that stage. And that is what will stead you, will stand you in tough time and crisis times. We have an economy which is growing at 5%. No other economy except maybe Argentina and Brazil for a short time is growing at that level, or maybe higher than that. 5% economic growth is a very big economic growth, whatsoever criticism it might be. China, whatever economic growth it is, 3% subtracted, because 3% is always propped up by the Chinese government through various means. So if they are growing at 6%, their actual economic growth is 3%. India, 5%, when we are saying it is not a good thing, it is one of the best in the world. And this is the time when you are there. The time is good. Times are going to be very tough, because the best will survive in the global corporate sector, in the Indian corporate sector, and the Indian professionals also. But if you are good, sky is the limit. Nothing less than that. So this is the opportunity within which you are entering an institute like this. Let me also tell that you have very lucky to have parents as who are sitting here. In India, I have worked with a lot of global societies and citizens. They don't bother about their children, about their education and what will be their careers. 15 years, 16 years, and that it is in the hand of the child himself. Here, the career, the grooming of a child, a parent takes that it is his responsibility. And if it is not good, he has failed. This is the type of accountability the parents take on themselves for their children. And you are very fortunate to have parents in India and who are going to put so much of money behind your education. You are among the top 15 or 20% lucky people in India at this age who are here, and parents are sacrificing their earnings for your future. The learnings which you have, the values which you have got from your parents, I will again repeat, make the anchors, make those as anchors of your life. Crisis, life, everyone goes through ups and downs. Downs is a must. It makes you a better human being, a better professional. But how will you fight that downs is through these values and anchors. In this time, coming to this institute, I know this institute since the first year. When I was heading the HR of LG and we came here, it was in a rented place. And Bala Saab asked me, can you just visit us? I always visited and talked to the students. And after talking to the students, I made up my mind whether LG will come in that institute or not. And the type of grooming and the type of training which this institute gives to the students is one of the best. Yeah, yeah. First time when I talked to the student, it was in 98 or 97, and I said, just after talking to the students and understanding what type of grooming these people are getting, we decided we'll come. And since then, every year LG is taking the biggest batch from this company, from this institute. And the students of this institute are now assistant general manager, heading a business. They have reached in 10 to 12 years those type of positions which a lot of people from best of the so-called best institutes have failed to do that. So this is one important thing. Coming back to the country, Peters, who wrote the book In Search of Excellence, whenever he talks to US corporate managers or the European managers, he says if you want to survive and learn business and grow, become a CEO of a company, go and work in India for 5 years. Because the systems, the political system, the economic system, the commercial systems in India are the most complicated. The market is very, very complicated, very complex, fragmented and complicated. And if you can understand that, you can work anywhere in the world. And you will be starting your career in India. Forget, there will be a lot of things. I worked in Singapore, Hong Kong, the learnings there are much less. I have worked all over the world. So I can tell you, learning in India is the biggest learning. Now coming to these type of institutes, knowledge is important. But knowledge is easiest to get because it's all available. Usage of knowledge is something which is tough and which makes a career of a person. It is, as Dr. Balasubramaniam also said, it is the attitude. Attitudes decides the altitude of a person where he'll go. Let me tell you this. If you are not positive in your attitude, if you are not ready to take challenging tasks, you cannot grow up. The mindset is very, very important. Go for the toughest thing and put your best foot forward. 50% you have won the war. When we were in LG, what we used to do, we used to take people from a lot of other companies. The mindset was the biggest issue. I'm not talking about the freshers, the other companies. And we created a training, which we said mindset training, and we broke the mindset of the employees. And how did we do it? We made them walk on fire. We made them play with the snakes. We had permission from WWF. Break the mindset. So when they did it, all these things, what they could not do, they said, I can do it. So let me try the toughest of the targets. And that is why till 3 years back, LG's growth was more than 35% every year. Unbelievable. So these two is the most important thing, and you have to focus, in addition to whatever inputs are given by the professors and the faculty, are the most important, which is in your hand. Don't be a negative minded, be positive. That is very, very important. Please understand, when you are going to enter the global, the business scene, it is becoming the most important in any country. India also, it is becoming important. It is not as considered to be as critical, but if you go to US, if you go to Europe, you go to Singapore, Hong Kong, economy, business is considered to be very, very critical. And I'll give you a very interesting example. When Golda Meir was the Prime Minister of Israel and Ronald Reagan was the President of US, she went and visited Ronald Reagan. And she said, Mr. Reagan, I have the two best generals, you give me two generals which I ask for and I will rule the world. So President Reagan asked her, which two generals you are asking? She said, Golda Meir was a lady Prime Minister of Israel, and she said, I have the two best soldier generals, you give me General Electric and General Motor and I will rule the world. So please understand, this is going to happen in India. The corporates, because what is going to be important in any economy, in any culture, is the machinery which is going to add value and which will make money. It is not the power of curbing and controlling. Those things are going away. I was listening to Alvin Toffler 30 years back, and that time he was advisor to Indira Gandhi for industrialization, and he had advice to Malaysia, Indonesian government, etc. And I asked him one question, the famous future shock person. And I asked him one question, because the debate of corruption should be stopped was even in those times. Now it is becoming a vote bank and a political stunt. And I asked him, what is more important for a country to grow? Shall we stop corruption? He said, no, that is the most serious and idiotic thing. Corruption cannot be stopped just by a legislature or executional body. Free your economy, corruption will go down. This is the most practical. If you, most of the people who want to keep the power with themselves become corrupt. And when the economy is kept under controls of the politicians and governments, then the corruption goes away. I was in LG. I need not talk to any politician because there was no controls. And even the central minister's phone used to come, I never used to pick the phone. But had I been in a different industry, I would have to toe their lines. And that is where the corruption started. This is the only way to stop corruption. Let me tell you this. And this is what has happened in most of the developing countries. Most of the developed countries which have undergone the phase of, they were when they were underdeveloped or developing countries. The controls have gone, corruption has gone down. If you don't have to go for certificates from someone, how can you ask for money? But then there are some other things which have to be done, added to that. Another thing, unbelievable things are happening in the industry. industry is going to be a power to be reckoned with. But it is always thought that the bigger the industry, bigger the company is more powerful. There was a case 5 years back, Tata Steel, which had a global market share of 8%, took over Chorus of England, which had a global market share of 22%. A dwarf taking over a giant. So this industrial scenario is undergoing an unpredictable changes. And that is why flexibility is one thing which will be very, very important for everyone. You will not have a path you have followed till yesterday is going to give you a success tomorrow. No. Because unexpected things are going to happen, very innovative things are going to happen, and you have to be ready for that. You have to be yourself as innovative, or new ways have to be tried. I sit in the board of selecting so many CEOs. I've been doing it for last 8 years. And any CEO during the interview, if he says, CEO or managing director, if he says, I have been very successful, we don't select him. We see CEOs, potential CEOs, who have failed. But what have they learned from their failure? Because if they have only seen success, their mindset is very rigid. And the past ways is the only thing which they want to follow. The past ways cannot be followed. Flexibility, humbleness of mind, this is what is required. Another thing, I'll give you one interesting example. Business Today comes out with every year, 50-year, Business Today is a business, very reputed business magazine in India. 50 young CEOs, best young CEOs, and I think young means less than 45 or 40 years of age. So about 5 or 6 years back, I said, okay, let me follow it up. They came out with 50 young CEOs, and incidentally, I knew 60 to 65% of them personally. Out of those 65%, 80% of them lost their jobs in the next 8 months. The best rated CEOs. So these are the expectations. What you have achieved is a hygiene factor, is a baseline. The benchmarks go up every year, every quarter. In US, the Vikram Pandit's case is very famous. He took over, Indian, who took over Citibank 3 or 4 years back. His Citibank was in doldrums. We all know Citibank. He started his job on $1 per month. But he said, if I turn it around, this is the bonus he will get. First year, he turned it around. 1 year turning around Citibank is a miraculous job. And he got a bonus of, can you guess how much? 250 crore rupees in terms of Indian rupees in 1 year. And second year, and he was sacked. This is what is performance. You cannot sit on laurels of the past. Every day is a new day. And those who are able to ready to face all this. So I'll give you 6 or 7 learnings which I have. It is tough, but only 7 laws will survive you. All the trainings will be there. These are all there, mindset, positiveness, learning, updating your knowledge everywhere. But laws of business are very weak. It is the spiritual laws which are the most important thing, which will take you to new heights. The first thing is law of giving. The more you will give, the more you will get. Most of the people talk it otherwise. The more you keep, the more you get. No. It is very simple. And these are very simple laws. The more love you give, the more love you get. The more power you give, the more power you get. Because you are free. You can do much more things, better things, add value to much more bigger things. The law of giving. Law of cause and effect. Very simple. The results which you are getting is because of your doings. Cause and effect. And these are eternal laws, the laws of spiritual laws. Third, whatever you are deciding, will that decision give happiness, contentment, and achieve what you want to the people who are associated with this decision, not only to you. Because the more you are self-centered, your decisions are going to be wrong. Because you will be deciding on your own beliefs, your attitudes, your intentions, and your greeds. And the more it is for containment, happiness, and what they want to achieve, the decision will be much correct. The law of least effort. Acceptance. What is the least effort? Right now, I know, when I started my career, I had a boss. And your first boss creates you or kills you. If your first boss with whom you are associated for 2-3 years, or second boss with whom you are going to be associated for 2-3 years, if he's a tough boss, your career is made. Don't run away from him. If he's pampering you, he's finishing you off. My first boss was a director in Tata Steel. I was fresh. And when he used to get angry, he used to abuse in Bhojpuri language, because he's from Bihar. He used to abuse in Bhojpuri and throw the paper, and he changed me and he made me what I am. Whatever I have achieved. The first boss is a very, very crucial thing. And you have to accept them. Learning does not come through only logic. Learning comes through acceptance of a person. Lot of things he will not explain. Lot of things the companies will, but you have complete acceptance of the company, company philosophy, company vision. That will change you. That will make you give extra. If you are skeptical about company or institute's vision, mission, philosophy, you will not give your best. Thank you. Law of intention and desire. What is your intention? I am telling you, if your intention is noble before you are taking a decision or you are going through a path, you have won half the war. The intention and desire, if it is greed, if it is self-centeredness, then it is half lost. Law of detachment. That even Gandhiji said. He told the corporate heads, treat this as a trust. If you are detached, your decision will be much more objective. If you are not detached, you will go for greed. Let me tell you, greed, there was a movie, Wall Street, in which, Michael Douglas was a hero. He said, greed is good. No, greed is not good. Greed kills. So there's a difference between money making, and there's a difference between profiting and profiteering. Profiting is okay, profiteering is bad. Law of pure potentiality. I suggest every day, half an hour, observe silence. What does silence mean? Silence simply means think in self. What have you done? Was it correct? There was a problem? You will find the right path. Think what you have done yesterday. Lot of people I have seen, 10 minutes before they sleep, just they think, they review the whole day. They get to know. This is, and brain, we are using only 5% of our brain. 95% we are not able to use. Heart, we are not using it at all. These are very strong, powerful tools which God has given for taking decisions. Another thing, I have a very strong belief, though a lot of people say no, only good human beings can be a good manager. It is not necessary that only good human beings will be a good manager, no. Good human beings might fail as a good manager, but a good manager has to be a good human being. Because what is required as a good manager? Leadership qualities. We feel that as bosses, we are seeing our subordinates. No, we are not able to see our subordinates more than 5%. We cannot read them. All the parents who are experienced people, only 5% or 10% we know about our subordinates. But the subordinate sees their boss with a lens. And they see each and everything. And if they see dichotomy in what he says and what he talks or what he does, if he sees he tells lies, his leadership is questioned, and when the leadership is questioned, the followership will not be there. Your execution will be very, very poor. So this is again very important. So if you are a good human being, it is not necessary you will be a good leader. But a good leader has to be a good human being. Very, very simple. And that is a tough thing, because you have to practice what you believe. And you have to walk the talk, and you have to decide and take actions on what you say. Very important. Don't, if you cannot do something, don't talk about it. These are golden rules, but it takes years to develop it in yourself. Years. Another thing is communication. I'll give you my example. I worked with Mr. J.R.D. Tata directly for two years, but early part of my career, every year for one day, Mr. J.R.D. Tata used to come to Tata Steel Jamshedpur on 3rd March, which was the Founders Day. And every year when he used to come, 2-3 young MBA graduates were introduced to him. So second year of my career, I was introduced to Mr. J.R.D. Tata when he came to Jamshedpur. So he asked me a question. Whatever name he called me, he says, "What have you learnt in 2 years?" So I thought, oh, I have to really impress Mr. J.R.D. Tata. Mr. J.R.D. Tata is somewhere there, no one is close to him and will ever close to him in the corporate sector. So I thought, I have to really impress him. So I spoke some jargons and this and that, and I thought I am really impressing on Mr. J.R.D. Tata. Mr. J.R.D. Tata looked at Mr. Rusi Modi. He was the chairman MD of Tata Steel, who expired about a month back. He was again a legend. And he told Mr. Modi, "Rusi, what are you teaching your young managers? If they cannot talk the language of a worker, they cannot be a manager." Very simple. Your communication has to be to the level of the person to whom you are talking. If he's a worker, you have to talk to him as a worker language. If you are talking to a salesperson, you have to talk in his language. Itna discount denge to itna maal jayega. If it's a manufacturing person, you have to talk in his language. If it's a marketing person, otherwise you are defunct. They will not listen to you. It is something like if you are talking to a child, if you talk at your level, the child will never become friend of yours. He will not listen, he will not understand. You have to talk in the language of the child. And this is very, very crucial. Learn. From that day, I practice, because naturally, what I read, I want to talk like that. What the type of people I interact, I want to talk to like that. But you have to really practice yourself. No, I'm doing something wrong. It's an ongoing practice which has to be there. And for being a good manager, some qualities. Last point. One is hard work. There is no shortcut to hard work. You might be hearing saying that is smart work, etc., etc. Hard work, there is no shortcut. Smart, you have to be. But smart means innovation, newer techniques. But it doesn't mean that if you are working 8 hours, 10 hours or 12 hours a day, you have to work 8 hours a day. No. The times are very tough. Manpower cost is going high, very, very high in the organization. No one can afford to have such costly people if they are not giving performance higher than the other people. They would like to have a cheaper person. I'll give you one example. In Germany, at the age of 52, there were 2-3 people who came here, and it's a practice. They were in software, Indians. At the age of 52, their salaries were reduced by 1/3. They went to their boss, the owner. The boss said, "I'm very generous with you, because the job which you are doing, younger people are ready to come at half the salary what you are getting now. So I've just reduced your salary by 1/3, but I'm paying you double than what others will do. So just go on with your work." This is a reality. What you are getting, if you are not giving back more than that to the organization, things will be tough. And that is why you have to be very hardworking, very innovative, courage. Decision making is nothing but courage. Trusting is lesser to do with love, more courage. Because if the accountability of running an organization is on me, and I am empowering people down the line, it is not because of love. Because I have the courage and the faith in them. And the courage that I'll face the consequences. This is what is. Courage is very important. Howard, 2 years back, their mate, 3 years back, they made Taekwondo as compulsory course for the MBA students. Not because they have to fight people, to give them courage. Yes, I can fight situations. Conscience. Never overrule your conscience. There's a very fine line between ethics and unethical thing. Never be an unethical manager. leave the job if it is unethics. Let me tell you, you will get bigger rewards outside the company. But the way the corporate governance rules have been framed in India now, and the so much of the grey areas are going away. If just the government decides to start a strong execution, I am telling you, half of the CEOs or managing directors of corporate sectors will be behind the bar. I am telling you, because I know the secrets. Your time, it will be much tougher. LG had an agreement with all the governments of the world that if they are found practicing any unethical practice in any part of the world, in any country of the world, they will stop business in all the world. These type of agreements have to be signed. Now, don't take a shortcut on ethics, never. Please, you might feel that you are taking two steps backwards at that particular point. Don't do that. Take it. Passion, missionary zeal. Dr. Balasubramanian, I am a big fan, he is a role model for me for one simple point. Passion and missionary zeal. And be a good listener. Higher we go, more educated we become, we stop listening. Be a good listener. Very, very important. These are something which is crucial. But one story is about passion. Dimple ji ko aap jante hain ki ek story hai. When she got married, she is there or no? Nahin. So I'll tell her in her absence. When she got married, so before the marriage, she and her fiancé met, the would-be fiancé met, introduced after marriage, after honeymoon first date. They were in a different city other than the city where their parents were. So she asked, first day when her husband was going to the office, she asked, okay, what will you have for lunch? He said, I'll have chicken and this and that, etc. She said, okay. But unfortunately, she didn't know how to cook. So she went and first thing she did was purchase the cookery book and purchase all the masalas and everything which was written. She went in the kitchen and put everything as per the book. So lunchtime when her husband comes, he finds there's no smell and she is very busy in the kitchen. So he went there. And he saw she is very busy, but there's no smell. That means there was nothing cooking. And then he saw that she had forgotten to lid the gas. The point is about the fire. Your parents, your institute is giving you an opportunity, an environment that you can groom. But unless you have that fire, nothing will happen. And that fire has to come out of your stomach. And that fire has to be 24/7 burning in you. And that is what is passion. And unless you can create that, and if you can create that, you have the future. Thank you very much.